Hi! Ever since I unboxed my biggest magnets, some of my cutlery has been magnetized. I guess this is normal when living in a house filled with monster magnets, but it is rather annoying. In this video, I'll attempt to demagnetize the cutlery with a demagnetizer tool. And since I wonder how this tool could possibly cancel a magnetic field, I will also take a closer look at how it works, including opening it up. What's inside it? Magic anti-magnets? Let's find out! No big hazards this time. Just be careful when using sharp tools and blowtorches. You may already know this magnetizer-demagnetizer tool. It is handy for making a screwdriver magnetic to hold a screw by itself and demagnetize it again when not needed. Works surprisingly well. But can it demagnetize my cutlery that has kept its magnetism for years? Yep, gone in seconds. How does it do that? I am not surprised it can magnetize something with high iron content. All you need is a magnet, like demonstrated here. But how do I remove the magnetism again? Use the opposite pole? Nope. Use the side of the magnet? No. Perhaps if I swipe the magnet in parallel. I could go mad professor on it and heat it above its curie point. But that's a subject for another video, since the demagnetizer clearly isn't using excessive heat to demagnetize. Let's look for some clues on how it works before I break it open to reveal its inner workings. The magnetizer part is just a rectangular opening. Nothing special to it. The demagnetizer part, on the other hand, has one rounded corner and a staircase inside it. Online sources say that the stairs are important. It will be interesting to see what's inside them. Another clue can be found if you have several of the two. They may look alike at first glance, but there is a difference. The two matching ones repel each other, while the odd one out is attracted. And not just on one side, it applies to both sides. If you are used to handling cube magnets, or watch my old buyer's guide for neodymium magnets, this is a big clue. One type makes the screwdriver's tip a magnetic south pole. Remember, opposite poles attract. The other makes it a north pole. Even more telling, I can only demagnetize the screwdriver with the same tool it was magnetized with. The other won't work. Clearly, polarity plays some role in the demagnetization. Time to bring out the big leak instrument, a Tesla meter measuring the magnetic field in 3D. At first, I just probed away, getting a lot of telling info, but it takes a trained eye to decipher all this info. I then remembered I have a beta firmware ready to install on the Tesla meter. The upgrade includes a graph feature, which is perfect for visualizing this measurement. First, you need to know the directions of the three axes. In the way I am holding the probe, the x-axis is up-down, y-axis is left-right, and z-axis is in and out of the screen. Alright, measuring the magnetizer opening first. Awesome. click like if you see the beauty in this as I do. Not only is this beautiful, it is highly useful. It tells us a lot about the magnetic field from the magnetizer. Most important, the green z-axis running parallel with the probe is by far the strongest, making up most of the total magnetic field strength drawn as a white line. In other words, the direction of the magnetic field in the magnetizer is mostly horizontal, in and out of the opening. Now, what about the demagnetizer part? Aha! This is a different magnetic field. Let's compare them side by side. Notice how the green z-axis has the opposite polarity and only is about a third as strong. The strongest axis is now the magenta x-axis, vertically up and down in the demagnetizer, though not nearly as dominant and strong as the z-axis in the magnetizer part. Enough with the clues. Let's open it up. Easier said than done. After an hour or so of precision smashing, I am ready for the big reveal. Have you figured out what's inside it, including the mysterious stairs? Here we go. That's it. It contains a couple of basic ferrite magnets and air. The magnets have the poles on their large surfaces and equal poles face each other in the magnetizer part. In the type that magnetizes the tip as a south pole, north poles face each other. And, of course, opposite in the one that turns the tip into a north pole. That explains the way they will combine. Magnets can only stick together side by side if their polarities alternate. The empty stairs have no significant effect on the magnetic field or demagnetizer function since they are just plastic and air. I can prove it easily. Watch this. The stairs are not needed for the demagnetization. Here's how I think it all works based on the evidence collected. In the magnetizer, the field is strong and parallel with the screwdriver shaft, magnetizing the screwdriver with the pole at the tip. In the demagnetizer, the field is weaker and more in a direction perpendicular to the screwdriver. But some of the field is still parallel with the shaft, just in opposite polarity. This more or less cancels the existing magnetic field in the screwdriver, and instead tries to create a new, weaker magnetic field, perpendicular to the shaft, making the tip act more like the weak side of a weak magnet, not like a strong pole on a stronger magnet when coming from the magnetizer part. After a short message, I will show you how to demagnetize without a demagnetizer tool, or a blowtorch. A big, big thanks to all my patrons. I appreciate your help with keeping these videos like this one coming. For just a dollar a month, you can help me out too and get full access to all my posts on patreon.com. Link in the description. Thank you. Earlier, I showed how to magnetize using a magnet, but failed to demagnetize using the same magnet. Here's how to do it. When magnetized with the unmarked pole should point towards the handle. Bingo! Watch the polarity. Now with the marked pole. So, no magic anti-magnets are needed, just a clever use and placements of the poles. Hope you liked this video enough to click like and subscribe for more discoveries. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.